Hello everyone, welcome to the course of Mechanical System Design, in which we are learning about design of IC engine components. In the last lecture, we learned how to design piston rings, and in this lecture, we will learn design of piston skirt. Please observe this diagram. The portion of the piston from top of the head to the bottom of the oil controller ring is called as barrel for all calculation purposes, and from bottom of the groove of the oil controller ring to the end of the piston is called as piston skirt. Its length is represented by LPS in this diagram. All other notations we have already seen in the last lecture, where B0 is the top land, B1 is the land between two piston rings, and BR is the axial width of the piston ring. D is the diameter of the piston. LP is the length of the total length of the piston. The function of a piston skirt is to bear the side thrust. Now let us understand from where the side thrust comes into the picture. When the engine is operating, piston moves from BDC to TDC and back to the BDC continuously. During this motion, only at two instances the connecting rod is vertical, when the piston is at TDC and when the piston is at BDC. Apart from these two instances, all other time the connecting rod is always at an angle. Due to this angle, there exists a component of the force which is in the radial direction of the piston, which is called as side thrust. Now this side thrust has to be borne by the entire piston. However, due to the presence of piston rings, the barrel is seldom subjected to side thrust, whereas the piston skirt keeps on touching the cylinder walls due to the side thrust. Hence, the piston skirt has to bear all the side thrust exerted by the connecting rod. Since the material of the piston skirt cannot be different from the material of the piston, it should have a similar desirable properties. However, some properties takes precedence over the material properties required for the barrel, such as low coefficient of thermal expansion, lightweight, wear resistance, low coefficient of friction, and good bearing properties. The reason being, most of the strength part to withstand the gas pressure and to transfer the heat is taken up by the piston barrel, whereas the piston skirt is taking care of side thrust forces. Therefore, the material used for the piston skirt is alloy steel and aluminum. In this figure, please note that Rn represents the side thrust. Let us move on to the design of piston skirt. The first parameter to be calculated is length of the piston skirt, denoted by LPS. First, we have to calculate the side thrust exerted by the connecting rod. The side thrust is assumed to be 5% to 10% of the maximum gas force. Thus, it is calculated as Rn into 0.05 to 0.1 times the maximum gas force. Maximum gas force is the maximum gas pressure multiplied by the cross-section area of the piston, given by pi by 4 d square. This equation gives the value of applied side thrust. This side thrust is resisted by the piston skirt, and the resistance is given by Rn equal to PVC into LPS into D, where LPS is the length of the piston skirt and D is the diameter of the piston. This is the projected area which is bearing the side thrust, whereas PBC is the permissible bearing pressure between piston skirt and cylinder wall, given in Newton per mm square. If we compare this action and reaction forces, then we get the formula for LPS by rearranging the terms, so that LPS is equal to 0.05 to 0.1 pi d square p max upon 4d pbc. The next parameter to be calculated is length of the piston given by LP. LP is equal to length of top land plus total width of piston ring plus total width of lands plus length of piston skirt. If we refer the figure previously, this formula makes sense. It is addition of the top land plus thickness of piston ring plus total land plus length of the piston skirt. Numerically, it can be written as LP equal to B0, which is the top land, Z, which are number of piston rings, BR is the axial width of the piston ring, plus Z minus 1 number of lands are available, into P1, that is width of land between two rings, plus LPS, which is length of the piston skirt. This one is the derived formula, whereas there exists one more formula which is empirical in nature, that is LP is equal to 1.75 times D. Another decision which a designer has to take is whether the reinforcement ribs are to be provided or not. The function of a reinforcement rib in a piston is to provide additional support to strengthen the head of the piston as well as skirt. These ribs originate from the piston pin boss up to the head, and on the other direction it originates from the piston boss of the piston pin to the skirt. If the thickness of the piston head, that is TPH, is less than or equal to 6 mm, ribs are not required. However, if it is greater than 6 mm, then ribs are required. Number of ribs typically used are 4 to 6, depending upon availability of the space inside the piston and ease of manufacturing. Thickness of each rib, that is TR, is calculated by TPH upon 3 to TPH upon 2. Let us understand this formula by solving the same numerical example which we have been solving from last two lectures. You may go through the problem statement carefully by pausing this video. Out of these six components, we have already designed first three components, so let us go ahead with design of piston skirt. Length of the piston skirt, that is LPS, has to be determined first, and for that the side thrust of the piston is calculated. It is given by this formula, and we are assuming 10% of the maximum gas force is resulting into the side thrust, and the value comes out to be 3927 Newton. This value we are comparing with the reaction offered by the piston skirt, and LPS can be calculated as 98.17, which is rounded off to 100 mm. Length of the piston, that is LP, is calculated by following formula. All the values in this formula has to be taken up by design of the piston rings, which we have solved in the last lecture. By putting all these values, we get LP equal to 137.5 mm. Since the thickness of the piston head is 16 mm, which is higher than 6 mm, reinforcement ribs are required in this design. The value of thickness of reinforcement ribs range from 5.33 to 8 mm. Therefore, we choose reinforcement thickness of the reinforcement ring as 6 mm. This is how the skirt of a piston can be designed. In the next lecture, we will design the last part associated with the piston, which is piston pin, which is also called as gudgeon pin. Thank you.